सर ये जो हमारा सैग रॉड और टाई रॉड होता है सर, इसमें हम जो डिजाइन करेंगे इनका सेक्शन सेम रखेंगे हम?
हाँ जी सर, आपका सेम होता है, ठीक है, वही डिजाइन।
मतलब सर वो सैग रॉड और टाई रॉड आपस में अटैच्ड होगा?
टाई रॉड जो है वो तकरीबन सेम होता है, वो टाई रॉड होता है, वो एक पर्लन को दूसरे पर्लन से कनेक्ट करता है ऑन दी बोथ साइड, ठीक है। तो वो सैग रॉड, तो उसका डाया वही रख लो जो सैग रॉड है, क्योंकि उसमें फोर्सेस वही होगी जो सैग रॉड में, क्योंकि उसने फोर्स एक सैग रॉड से दूसरी तरफ ट्रांसफ़र करनी है, तो जो फोर्स सैग रॉड में है वही टाई रॉड में होगी। तो इफ़ यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग द सेम डाया फॉर द टाई रॉड एज ऑफ सैग रॉड, दैट विल बी सफिशेंट। सो यू गॉट इट?
यस सर, ओके सर।
So have you already completed the table of forces? So if someone is having any question from table of forces, so what I'm expecting, maybe I will give you the deadline of 2 weeks. So you are supposed to submit maybe a report on the world. So that must include the panel load calculation and table of forces and also design of Perlin and design of sag rod and also the number of sheets, corrugated sheets. And also we have already completed the design of tension member, so you can start designing the member which are in tension. And also today inshallah we are going to discuss the last lecture related with the compression member. So after today's lecture you will start designing all member of your truss. So depending upon maybe stress reversal condition. So regarding the guideline, I have already explained you that for top chord and bottom chord member, you need to consider a double angle section. And for the interior member, you can use any lighter member that may be the angle or channel. But do not select the W section, because if you are selecting the W section, we need the gusset plate on the both side. So bottom and top chord member will be double angle and interior member will be any lighter member, maybe out of angle or channel. Yes, Uzair, please ask the question. Uzair, yes.
Sir, ये जो हम पहले report submit करवाएंगे, like जिस तरह आप 2 weeks कह रहे हैं, तो sir इसमें हमने जो काम submit करवाना है वो किधर तक जो है वो हमारा complete होना चाहिए?
I'm expecting panel load calculation, table of forces, and design of Perlin and roof sheeting, corrugated roof sheet design. So maybe I will give you more time for the completion of compression member design for the truss. ठीक
है? Okay.
Yes, Hamza, what is your question? Yes, Hamza. Haan ji, 300 mm. That actually just, this is a cantilever portion that we extend beyond this four, theek? You may consider maybe 400, but minimum we consider 300 mm. So 300 mm is around maybe 1 foot. You got it? So we need to, we need to extend, okay? So uska koi issue nahi. Yes, Mohsin Rana, what is your question? Mohsin, please, if you are having any question, please ask.
Sir, ye humne just interior truss se design karni hai ya?
Only interior one. Actually, what is the concept? If you know how to design the interior truss, so it means that you also know how to design the exterior. Procedure is the same. You understand me? So the basic main objective is to give you the hand-on practice, to get you familiar that what is the design procedure and how we design the truss member and how we are calculating the panel loads. So you are only supposed to design the interior truss, because if you know how to design the interior, it means that you also know how to design the exterior. So no need to repeat, just design one what I must say, interior truss. So actually today I have downloaded all the video lecture, maybe only for the last week lectures are not being downloaded at the moment. So by this weekend I will share only this recording of selected lecture, and also I will give you the assignment from the tension member design and compression member design. Yes, Mubin, Uzair, main aapka question baad mein, pehle Mubin ko batane do. Mubin, what is your question?
Sir, सर ये जो हमने टेबल के साथ वो रिपोर्ट भी सबमिट करवानी है तो रिपोर्ट में सर हम वी हैव टू राइट द प्रोसीजर और जस्ट कैलकुलेशन शो करनी
है जस्ट डिजाइन कैलकुलेशन ओके एंड वेरी ब्रीफ मे बी डेफिनेशंस ओनली सो इट दैट मस्ट नॉट बी यू आर नॉट सपोज्ड टू सबमिट द टेक्स्ट बुक यू आर जस्ट सबमिटिंग द रिपोर्ट ओके जस्ट कैलकुलेशन the way we have done in our class we have solved example so similarly you have to solve okay yes Uzair again you are having question yes Uzair please ask
sir kuch to cheeze aisi hain like table of forces wagaira is tarah ki calculation wo to hum excel wagaira pe karenge lekin sir wo design mein jo choti moti jis tarah hum example wagaira mein calculation karne hai sir wo page ke upar likh kar bhi ki ja sakti hai ya wo word ke upar humne type karke report send karni hai
nahi nahi aap page ke upar bhi likh sakte ho page ke upar likh ke isko scan kar do theek hai
okay sir
samajh gaye लेकिन एक्चुअली उसमें सारी कैलकुलेशंस आपकी होनी चाहिए यू कैन टेक द कंसल्टेशन ऑफ द अदर स्टूडेंट बट यू आर नॉट सपोज टू कॉपी ओके ये नहीं है कि आपने स्टार्ट पे अपनी कैलकुलेशन की है बाकी किसी का छापा लगा दिया सो यू कैन गेट द कंसल्टेशन और दे मे बी हेल्प ऑफ अदर स्टूडेंट बट यू शुड हैव योर ओन कैलकुलेशन बिकॉज एट द एंड व्हेन यू विल आई विल आल्सो टेक अ वाई वॉस एग्जामिनेशन सो आई विल आस्क हाउ कम यू हैव कंप्यूटर द पैनल लोड कैलकुलेशन प्लीज एक्सप्लेन हाउ यू डिजाइन दिस मेंबर एंड हाउ यू गॉट दिस लोड सो डेफिनेटली यू आर एक्सपेक्टिंग मे बी अ वेरी रिगोरस वाइवा बट डोंट नीड टू वरी ओके इफ यू हैव डन द वर्क योर सेल्फ सो इनशाला देर विल बी नो प्रॉब्लम इन योर ग्रेड्स सो एनीबॉडी सो शुड आई स्टार्ट द लेक्चर So maybe the 37 students, 38 students are already there. So first of all, let me share the slides. Maybe. So can you see the slides, gentlemen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, please now mute your mics. So last time, actually, we have discussed this design flow for the built up design with lacing so now we are going to solve one example so this is the example design a column of length 8 meter and it is pinned at both ends and consisting of two channel placed back to back so total length of the column is 8 meter and both ends are pinned so no bracing is used because information is not provided regarding the bracing so it mean that so maybe I think have I started the recording so I will explain again so bismillah rahman rahim in today's example we are going to design a built up section for a 8 meter long column which is pinned at both ends and it is consisting of two channels placed back to back at a distance of 250 mm so the total length of the column is 8 meter both ends are pinned so it means that the k value effective length factor will be 1 about both axes because we are not given the information regarding the end condition about any of axes if no information is given so it means that we need to consider the k value same about both axes and similarly no bracing is provided about any axis so unbraced length about x axis and y axis will also be the same which is 8 meter so they are placed back to back for example like this they are two channel so they are placed back to back or flanges turn outside and will with a clear gap of 250 mm so clear distance between the outer face of web is 250 so we are supposed to use this type of arrangement and also we need to connect the lacing by fastener which is the rivet and diameter of the rivet we have to use as a 15 mm and we are directly provided with the effected compressive load so actually for a built up section with lacing we cannot consult the column selection table because column selection table are only available for double angle with gusset plate or with stay plate or we are having for W section or for single angle and for any other type of built up section especially with lacing we have to start the design by assuming R value or by assuming the slenderness ratio so AISC recommends that for the built up section design design can be started by assuming slenderness ratio or the R value equal to 70. So PU is given, so effective length is 8 meter. So corresponding to R value 70, you can consult the page number, I guess that will be page number 105. And do I need to show you the table? I guess you already know. You can consult page number 105 in LRFD manual. So corresponding to slenderness ratio 70, the critical stress at which the column with slenderness ratio may buckle is 173.53. So we can determine the area required for two channels dividing the factored compressive load by assumed critical stress value. And in this equation, we are supposed to use the consistent unit, or all value must be in Newton and millimeter. Area required for two channel is 18,440, and area required for one channel will be 9,220 if we are dividing it by two. Now, from reference one, so when I write the reference one, it means that LRFD design aid, we can select the channel section from section properties table for channel. So I think we are having three options. Maybe one option is 2C is 380 into 74, and 2C is 310 into 74, and 2MC is 330 into 74. It means that all three sections, they are having same weight. So it means that you can select any one section for the trial section. For trial section mean that to apply the capacity check. So actually, we are not recommending to use the larger depth for the member, truss member. Because if we are using the larger depth, then the design for the gutter plate, if the member is belong to truss, will be larger. But anyhow, out of these three options, this depth is very large. You already know that maybe I had maybe one slide. So maybe I need to use other sharing option. I think it was not saved. I sketched last time for the other section, but anyhow, no problem. So again, so we are selecting this section because this, if depth is very less, this section is having Rx value very less. Actually, what is the advantage of designing a built-up section? By designing a built-up section, actually, we are increasing the moment of inertia about y-axis, or we are enhancing the radius of gyration about y-axis. So a built-up section is having the radius of gyration about x-axis same as of channel section. So if depth will be lesser, Rx value will be lesser. Similarly, if depth will be more, then Rx value will be larger. So if depth is larger, it means that the width of section may be less. So there may be chance of local instability in this section. So actually, we have picked this 2MC 330 into 74 as a trial section. So you can pick any because all are having same weight. So if weight of this section is 70 and these are heavy, so always select the section which is having the lesser weight, lighter one. But if the weight of three options, the three section are same, so then you can select any one section. So we have selected this 2MC 330 into 74. From section properties table, you may write area, Rx value, Ry, D, thickness of the web, thickness of the flange for the section, and width of the flange. First of all, you will check the local instability. So local, you will check flange local buckling. So in case of channel, flange local buckling is checked dividing the BF value by TF. because BF value is the width of this flange and divided by thickness of this flange. So this value is 7.23 and it is less than 12.7. So the flange is safe against buckling. Similarly, you will check the flange local web local buckling, height of the web divided by thickness of web. So height of the web actually that is the distance from inner face of top flange to the inner face upper face of bottom flange, so between the flange. So if we know the total depth minus thickness of the flange from one side and thickness of the flange from the other side will be the height of web. So D value is 330 flange, and we are having height of the web divided by thickness of web, which is 20, and answer is 14.95, which is less than 42.3. So the section is safe against web buckling. Okay, here for the built-up section, you may compute the exact value for Rx and Ry, but if you are having limited time, then you can consult this approximate formula here for two channel plates back to back. B is the clear distance between the web and H is the height of web. So Rx approximate is 36% of the height value and Ry is 0.6 time or 60% of the width, which is a clear distance between the web. So these formula you can use to estimate the approximate value of Rx. So if examination you are having limited time, so you can use this approximate formula. But for your calculation of the truss design, you're supposed to compute the exact values. So here, Rx approximate is 0.3x time of the B, which is 118.8, and Ry approximate is 60% of H value. Actually, I guess there are some errors. This will be the H and this will be the B value. So Ry approximate is 150. Okay, further, here you will see that Ry approximate value is larger than Rx approximate. So it means that if you are computing the actual value, so actual value of radius of gyration about x-axis will also be lesser than exact value of radius of gyration about y-axis. So it means that R minimum is the Rx. And actually you are already know the exact value of Rx, because Rx value for the built-up section is same as of the single section. We have already discussed. So for example, I will just write here for your convenience. So this one. So radius of gyration about x-axis for a built-up section is same as of single section. So we already know the Rx value of single section, which is 117. If you know the exact value of 117, then you better use exact value. But anyhow, in this problem, we have used the approximate value. So that will not make a large difference in the calculation. So exact value of Ry should preferably be calculated for the last trial. In case of lacing, individual slenderness ratio is usually very small and modified slenderness ratio will be very close to the original slenderness ratio. Actually, we are not computing the modified slenderness ratio for built-up section with lacing. We only supposed to use the or compute the modified slenderness ratio for built-up section with stay plate. Why the reason? Because reason is maybe I am having because reason is that in case of built up section with lacing, so this A value is very small if we are computing. So when we design, for example, here, this example with stay plate, I will show you so that where is the calculation? Yes, here. So A, here, when we computed the A value, so A value came out to be yes, here. So yes, A value, just see what is A value. It is around 1.3 meters, 1.6 meters. So this A value is very large. So we are computing modified Schneiderlin ratio by this formula. If A value is large, then this formula will give a very different value for the modified Schneiderlin ratio. If A value is less, very small, so this factor is almost insignificant. So modified Schneiderlin ratio will be equal to the governing Schneiderlin ratio about y-axis. So we will see when we are solving the numerical. So we will check the capacity. Schneiderlin ratio is effective length divided by R minimum, and R minimum is 118.8. You may also use 117. And this Schneiderlin ratio is coming as a 68. So if this is 68, corresponding to Schneiderlin ratio 68, you can consult the phi CFCR value from the page number 105. Corresponding to Schneiderlin ratio 68, phi CFCR value is 176.09. So we will determine the capacity. Capacity is equal to phi CPN, phi CFCR multiplied by the 2 times area of channel. So phi CPN is coming out to be 3338, which is more than PU. So our built up section is satisfying the capacity check. Okay, next is we need to design for the lacing. So for lacing, actually I told you that for lacing it will be also designed as a compression member. So for the compression member, we need the length of lacing, and we know the how much factored force is acting in lacing. So here so I have explained from here. So the total shear force which is acting in this direction, transfer, in transversal direction, is equal to the 2% of the compressive or the capacity of this built-up section. So AISE says that do not compute actual shear force which is acting in the transversal direction. So we may consider the total shear force which is acting in the transversal direction as a 2% of capacity. So that is computed. So next is we need to take the decision regarding single lacing or double lacing. So decision is based upon this slide here. So we decide regarding the single lacing or double lacing depending upon the S value. If S value is less than 380, we have to consider single lacing. And for the single lacing, starting angle will be 60 degree. Effective length of lacing will be total length of lacing member. So So, gentlemen, I need to pick the calls. Just.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I was explaining that at the start, we need to take decision regarding single lacing or double lacing. So, decision will be taken based on the S value. So, what is S value? So, S value I have already explained. Maybe which slide? So, on this slide. So, this is the S value. S value is the center to center distance between two rows of fastener. So, from the row of the fastener on the one section to the center of the hole on the second section or the other section. So, this is the S value. So, if we know the S value, based upon the S value, we can decide about the single or double lacing. So, S value I have already explained to you. So, if we are having this case, so S value is will be B minus 2 times of G value because S is from here to here. So, G value is a fixed value. So, you might remember that in our tension member design, I have shown you one table which is available in LRFD manual. So, this gauge value or the gauge distance is constant for any channel depending upon width of NAND. So, we are having this case. So, G value will be from here to this center of the hole. So, S value will be equal to B plus 2 times of G value. So, from here, so we will compute the S value. So, S value in this case will be B plus 2 times of G value. So, page number 100, LRFD design aid. So, if width of the flange is more than 100, then G value is 64. Our BF value is 112. So, G value will be 64 in our case. So, when we are computing the S value, so S value is the B plus 2 times of G. So, answer is 378. So, S value is coming out to be less than 380. It means that we supposed to use single lacing. And for single lacing, what will be the other design guideline? Yes. For single lacing, we have to limit it our slenderness ratio 140 and effective length will be equal to total length of lacing. So if we are using double lacing, so effective length will be 0.7 times of the total length. And starting angle will be 45 and slenderness ratio for our lacing will be used as a 200. So, we are using this. Okay, next is, actually, here we need to check. Actually, here I have used the L value, you can use this A. L is the effective length and L is the distance of unconnected flange or the length of the flange plate between two consecutive fasteners on one section. So, I am referring this as a earlier, but you can either refer this value as a length, distance from here to here, or you can refer as a value. So, we need to make sure that for this flange plate only. So, slenderness ratio of this flange plate between the center of this fastener to the center of this consecutive fastener should be less than equal to 75% of the governing slenderness ratio. Governing slenderness ratio means slenderness ratio of built-up section. We have studied this over here. This one we have derived. So A here you can show this as a over R minimum for the flange plate should be less than equal to 75% or 3/4 of R value. So R minimum for a flat plate is equal to BT cubed divided by 12 divided by area. We have already derived that for any plate, R minimum is equal to 0.289 times of the thickness of the plate, in our case, which is the flange. So after simplification, 4.61 of the A over thickness ratio of divided by thickness of flange plate should be less than R value. That we supposed to check over here. So, how we can compute this A value or L value, you can either show by L or A. We know the S value. S is the distance from this dash line to the dash line. So this dash line is the center line, the line which is passing through the centroid of fastener on one section. So S value is from here to here that we already know, which is 378. So we can easily determine this length. So this angle is 60. Whatever is this angle will be same, or this angle will also be same. So this length is the L by 2 or A by 2. We know this S value, which is perpendicular, and this is the base that we intend to determine, and we need to determine, we know this angle. So S over L by 2 will be equal to tangent theta. By solving this equation, we can determine the length value, and this length is coming out to be 437. So we know the length. Now we will check this condition. 4.61 time of this length, which is 437, divided by thickness of the flange, and this answer is coming out to be 130, which is more than 68. 68 is the slenderness ratio of our built-up section. This means that slenderness ratio of this flange plate is larger. So flange plate will buckle before overall buckling will occur in our built-up section. So how it means that how we can reduce this length? So this length can only be reduced if we are increasing this angle. If this angle is increasing, so these 2 points, they will come closer, so length will be reduced. So I will explain one alternative method just for your understanding. So you can reverse calculate the values. So alternative is that you will equate this value equal to R value, because that is expression. Why it is halting? So here so actually there is some issue. Anyhow, here, so I will use the same expression, and I will determine that what should be the maximum length I may provide. So keep the length as an unknown. Thickness of the flange is 15.5 in our case, and this R value is 68. So in this equation, only unknown will be the length. So you can determine what is the length maximum that you may provide. That will be equal to 68 multiplied by 15.5 and divided by maybe 4.61. So the answer will be, so I'm computing on my cell phone, so you also better to calculate. So 68 multiplied by 15.5 and divided by 4.61. So this answer is coming out to be at 228. So this is the maximum length that we may provide. So this length should be less than 228 to avoid the flange buckling of flange plate before overall buckling. So it means that now, so here, so this is L maximum. So we can use maximum this value. So it means that we are supposed to use the length value less than this 8. So say you can use this length value, any value less than 228. You may use either 220 or maybe 200 So any value if you are using less than 228, that will be satisfied. Okay, if you want, you may use 225, lesser value. So actually, now what I will do, this is the L maximum. So I need to use the L value lesser than this value. Let's suppose I'm using 225. So what I will do, I will substitute the value here back to this equation, and I will compute the angle. So in this equation, so I will use this value as a 225, let's suppose. And I already know the S value, which is coming out to be 378. So I'm computing that what angle I should, maybe I need to apply. So here, tangent theta will be 2 into 378 divided by 225. And if you are computing the angle, so angle will come around maybe 73 degrees. So this angle will come around 73 degrees. It means that we need to increase the angle from 60 degree to 73. If we are using this angle, then our length will be less than L maximum and our flange plate will be safe against buckling. So you can round this value. So say you will round to the multiple of 5 degree on upper side. So you are adopting this value as a 75. So this is the proper way to reverse calculate the angle. So if check fail, then you back calculate what is the L maximum, and you need to provide the length of flange plate less than L maximum, and depending upon this you can check this angle 75 degree. So you need to do this operation if your this check fail. Starting angle will always be 60 degree. So here, so this is by hit and trial, so angle is changed from 60 to 75. But the actual procedure, why we opted the 75, I have explained. So if we are increasing the angle, so this plate will become more mild downward side, so distance between them will reduce. So for theta 75, L will be 203. So when you are using the angle 75, so you need to compute L again for 75. Just here, because this was the theta 73 for the length 225. So when angle is 75, then recalculate L value for 75 degree. So L value will be 203. Okay, here see, this L actually, this is the A value. This A value is very small, 203, as compared to the distance between stay plate, which was maybe 1300 millimeter. So that's why we don't need to compute the modified slenderness ratio for built-up section with lacing. So again, you don't need to check this thing again, because if you have reverse calculate the answer by this procedure. But anyhow, if you want to check again, so slenderness ratio of flange plate is less than 68. Okay, next is shear force. Actually, it is acting in this direction. So last time I have explained. So here, so shear force is acting in this direction, this shear force. So we need to convert this shear force, or we need to determine the component of this shear force along this length, because we need the compressive force in this length. And I have also told you that at one plane, for example here, we are having two lacing, one lacing on one side and one lacing on the other side. We are connecting the flange on the both sides with lacing. It means that total shear force which is transferring or acting in the transversal direction is resisted by lacing at two plane, or it is divided by two. So n value will be two. So VU will be divided by n. N is the number of shear plane, lacing plane, that will always be two. Actually, we know this component. So this angle and this angle will be same. Actually, we need the force here. We already know this shear force, this component. So this angle, this is the vertical, and this is the hypotenuse. So S over, and we are, sorry, S, no, not S, this force is V over N divided by this hypotenuse, which is FU, will be equal to sine theta. It means that if I'm dividing VU by N by sine theta, I will be having a force FU, which is acting along the length of lacing. So FU is the compressive force which is produced in lacing, for which we need to design lacing bar as a compression member. So FU will be VU over N sine theta. VU is, we already computed, 66.8. I will show you again, which is actually 2% of capacity of built-up section. So VU divided by number of plane divided by sine theta, we are having compressive force which is acting along lacing, which is 34.6. Actually, next is we need to determine the length of lacing, effective length. Effective length of lacing is the inclined distance from the center of this fastener to the center of fastener on the other side. So we already know the S value, and we know this theta, so we can determine this length of lacing. So this angle and this angle is same. So it means that LE will be equal to S divided by sine theta, that you can see over here. L is equal to S sine theta, 378 divided by sine 75 is equal to 391. And for single lacing, effective length will be equal to this total length, 391. If it is double, then we need to multiply it by 0.7. Okay, next. Now, we know the length of lacing, and we need to consider the flat steel plate, and we know the FU. So, design of the lacing is based upon these four conditions. Number one is slenderness ratio. So, you know that for the compression member, we always start the design by assuming the slenderness ratio. For single lacing, we have to start the design by assuming the slenderness ratio 140. And if we know the slenderness ratio, based upon slenderness ratio, we may compute the phi c fcr value based upon LE over R 140. We can check what is the phi c fcr value for single lacing. And then if we know this, then FU divided by phi c fcr, we can determine the area for the lacing, area required for lacing. And actually, I have already explained to you that for slenderness ratio 140, we already know what is the R value, because R value for the flat plate is equal to BT cube divided by 12 divided by BT. So we already know the R minimum. So R minimum will be 0.2890. It means that if we know the length and we are keeping the slenderness ratio 140, so only R minimum will be equal to 0.289, so only unknown will be thickness. And if we determine the thickness, we will round to the upper side, and after rounding to the upper side, we can determine the actual R minimum, and we may know the actual slenderness ratio, and based on actual slenderness ratio, we may have phi CFCR value. And we already have determined the thickness, so only unknown will be B. So this is the minimum width of flat lacing required to satisfy the compressive forces. There is another criteria, which is for local stability. Because this flat plate is a compression member, we need to check local buckling. And local buckling of this plate will be determined by B over T ratio, which should be less than 10.8. So we already know the T, so we will also determine one B maximum value, maximum B that we may provide. Then four criteria for the practical condition or for the field installation. So I told you that maybe in previous lecture. So we need to provide a minimum edge distance to the center. So minimum edge distance is 1.5D from this side and 1.5D on the other side. So total length of the lacing will be effective length of lacing plus 2 times of 1.5D. That is the minimum length that we need to provide. Similarly, we need to provide the minimum edge distance on this side, which is 1.5D, and minimum edge distance on the other side, which is also 1.5D. So B minimum is equal to 3D for practical reasons. So we will determine the 3B value, and out of the 3 value, we will use the appropriate value for our lacing design. So we are almost covered. So properties of the flat plate, area of the flat plate is equal to B into T. So I minimum, this will always buckle about this y-axis. This x-axis. So I minimum will be B T cube divided by 12. So I minimum is B T cube divided by 12, and R minimum will be equal to I minimum divided by area. So R minimum is 0.2890. So at the start, we are assuming that slenderness ratio of single lacing is equal to 40. We are equating as a 140. LE value we already know, which is 391, that we have determined from here, length of the lacing, effective length. And then R minimum for this flat lacing is equal to 0.289 times of thickness. We are equating it to 140. So T value is coming out to be 9.64. So thickness, we have to use the any thickness larger than this value. So we are using as a 10 mm. So I will explain that in the market, the thickness of the plate is available in following order. As maybe 5, 8, 10, maybe 12, 15, 18, 20, 22, 25, 28, and 30. So thickness is only available in following order. So here, how to remember this? So just remember 10, 15, 20. 10 is the even number. So after even number, add the even value 2. 15 is the odd. After 15, add the 3, which is the odd, so 18. So if you are having the thickness more than 8, then we will use the thickness on the upper side as a 10. So we have computed the thickness as a 9.6. So, but available thickness in the market is 10, so we are using 10. Okay, if your answer would be 10.5, then we're supposed to use the thickness as 12. So in market, the thickness of the plate is available in following order. So we have computed a thickness 9.64, but available size on upper side is 10 millimeters. So we are going to use plate as a 10 mm. So since we are using the plate thickness as a 10, so we now will compute the revised R minimum. Because R value T was 9.64 for 140. So we will compute the actual slenderness ratio again. So R minimum will be equal to 0.289 times of thickness, 10. So we will compute the actual slenderness ratio again. LE 390 divided by R minimum, which is 135.3. So we are assuming this value is 136. So corresponding to slenderness ratio 136, page number 106. So our 5C FCR value is 84.24. So 84.24. So now we are using this equation. Fu we know. So corresponding to 136, we know the phi CFCR value. Area is equal to B into TT, already known. So only unknown is the B value. So Fu value is 34.6 that we have determined here. So phi CFCR value is 84.24, force underness ratio 136, and area of lacing is equal to B into T. So we already know the thickness, so only unknown will be B value. So this is the minimum B value required to satisfy the check, strength check, or the failure of the lacing against compressive forces. Third condition is that B over T ratio we will equate into 10.8, and this will be the B maximum. So T value is 10, so B will be equal to 10.8 into B a T, so this is 100. So our B value may be from 41 to 1.12, 108, we can use any thickness. For our practical reason, to provide the sufficient edge distance, B minimum should be 3 point of the D. D is the diameter of fastener, so from here, so B minimum is coming out to be 45. So we are having two minimum. So larger value out of two minimum will be our B minimum. So our width of the lacing plate should be between 45 to 108. And we will round to the multiple of 10. So better to use the value as a 50. So we are rounding to the upper side in the multiple of 10. Even you want to use 45, that is also okay. But round to the upper side, because we can use any value between them. So that will be 50. And thickness will be 10. So that will be lacing. Okay, now we need to, B is 150, B we are using 50. So minimum length of lacing is effective length plus 3 times of the T value that I have explained from here. Okay, so total length is L. That is the minimum length, 3D. Actually, you can extend the length until this edge. We will see. But anyhow, if you want, don't want to extend, that is okay. So provide 50 into 10 mm flat plate, and length should be 425. Round this length to the multiple of 25. Even you are using 410, that is also okay. But round to the multiple of 25. So length should not come outside the width. We can extend the length until the edge. Okay, next is the design of the N-type plate that I have already explained. So width, this N-type plate will be used this. So this is the width. So width will be equal to total B value. So in our case, this will be equal to the, we will compute, I will show you diagram. This will be equal to the spacing between the web plus width of the flange. So total width of the entire plate will be equal to total width of the section. And the length will be equal to S value. And S value is 378. And the thickness of this plate will be S by 50. So here, in this case, total width of the N-type plate will be from here to here. So we know this distance 250, 250 plus flange width from the one side and flange width on the other side. So in this case, we may have the total width of N-type plate required. So thickness of the N-type plate should be more than S by 50. So S by 50 is, answer is 7.56. Available thickness of the plate is 8 mm. Just like I have given you the order of the plate. Minimum length is S, and the width of the tie plate is equal to width of the section. Distance between the web plus 2 times the BF value. So N tie plate will be used as a 8 into 470. and 470. So we may use this n-type layer. So maximum this value is 474. So you can use maybe 380 and 380 also. So this length cannot be more than 374. Plate should not be outside the edges. So plate may be less than the total width, but may not be larger to this. So rounding to the downside in the multiple of 10 mm. So this will be n-type layer. So I will send you the assignment by on the weekend. So this is the end of our compression member. So now I would like to take the question. So if anyone is having the question, he can ask me. So maybe 10 minutes ago, the students were 36. Now they are 40. So now I will mark the attendance. And then I will have the break, and then we will have the question answer session. So your section is B. Roll number 8, 2016, roll number 8.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
99.
99, relegated 2016 student. 93, 2017 session 56, 2018, 56 is there or not? Okay, 58?
Yes, sir, present, 58.
Please also speak your roll number, okay?
58.
Okay, good. 59?
Yes, sir, 59.
60? 61?
Yes, sir, 61.
62?
Yes, sir, present 62.
63?
Yes, sir, present 63.
64?
64, present, sir.
Okay, 67? Okay, good. 68?
Present.
68? आप रोल नंबर भी बोले ना
प्रेजेंट
नहीं अपना रोल नंबर बताओ ना 60 यस गुड 69 ओके
69
ओके 70
यस सर 70
एंड 71
यस सर 71 प्रेजेंट
72
यस सर 72
ओके 73
यस सर 73 प्रेजेंट
74
Yes, sir, 74.
75? 75?
Nahi, 75. 76? Yes, sir, 76.
Okay, 77?
Yes, sir, 77.
78?
Yes, sir, 78.
79?
Yes, sir, 79.
80?
Yes, sir, 80.
81? 81? 82? 82? 83? 84? 85 of 2017 session.
Yes, sir, 95.
Okay. 96? 96?
Yes, sir, 96. Yes, 90, sir, 96.
Okay. 97? 97 for 2008.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And again, 97 for 2017 session. 97 for 2017 session. Okay, 98 रोल नंबर भी बोले ना आपको बताया मुझे
yes, sir, 100.
Okay, good. 101. 101.
Yes, sir. 101.
Okay. 102.
Yes, sir. 102. Present.
103.
Yes, sir. 103.
And 104. Okay. 290. 290.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I got you. 65.
Yes, sir. Present.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Present.
Okay. Bhogi Marko. Okay. Here I'm going to give you a break and break of maybe 15 minutes. And after 15 minutes, so we will have another session, maybe question answer session. So I will maybe start the lecture. Time with me is 11:08. So I will start at 11:25. So I will take the question from you. Oh, can we please hold on? So I am surely I'm going to take your question too. Mark at my attendance 102. So in the meantime, if someone is having the question, please use the raise hand option. Please raise the hand. I will answer your question one by one. Yes, Mubin, please ask the question.
Yes, sir, ये जो हमारा बी मिनिमम 145 और दूसरा 41.1 आया था, इसमें से हमने लार्जर वाला लिया था, तो हम फाइनल में ये 45 एग्जैक्ट भी ले सकते हैं या हम राउंड ऑफ करना मस्त?
आप ये एग्जैक्ट भी ले सकते हैं, लेकिन बात का होता है हम इसको अपर लिमिट में 10 का मल्टीपल ले लेते हैं. आप वो भी 45 भी ले सकते हैं, कोई इशू नहीं है, लेकिन टू बी ऑन पेपर. हाँ जी,
तो सर वो हमने वो टाइप लेट के डिजाइन में वो हमने उनको उसको डाउनसाइड पे राउंड क्यों किया?
यस, वो बताता हूँ. अभी ये स्लाइड नजर आ रही है? नहीं, अभी ठहर के जरा एक मिनट. जस्ट कैन यू सी दिस स्लाइड?
यस सर.
नजर. अच्छा, मुझे ये बताओ डाउनसाइड इसलिए राउंड किया कि वो 74 यहाँ की टोटल वेट है, 374 फ्रॉम हेयर टू हेयर. ओके, इट्स मीन दैट प्लेट कैन नॉट बी एक्सटेंडेड आउटसाइड, बट इट कैन बी साइज कैन बी लिटिल बिट रिड्यूस्ड. ठीक है, आप एग्जैक्ट बी भी ले सकते हैं या उसको थोड़ा सा कम भी रख सकते हैं. द विथ मे और मे नॉट बी इक्वल टू द फुल विथ ऑफ सेक्शन. यू गॉट मी?
यस सर.
ओके, आई विल गिव यू द हिंट. बिकॉज द लेंथ वॉज 474, ओके, सो इट इज ऑलवेज बेटर दैट आवर डायमेंशन शुड बी इन द मल्टीपल ऑफ 5 मिलीमीटर और 10 मिलीमीटर. सो यू कैन नॉट यूज दिस डायमेंशन 475 और 480. Because if you are using 475 or 80, then the edges will come outside. They will be extended beyond the width. But you can reduce the length, okay, to the downside. So width may be less than the total width. So when you are rounded the 474 into the multiple of 10, so maybe 2 millimeter less from this side and 2 millimeter less from the other side. So it is not going to make any difference. You got it?
ओके, यस सर.
ओके,
सर वो नियरेस्ट को राउंड करेंगे, नियरेस्ट जो होगा.
नहीं, 474 है ना, तो 470 आ गया. ठीक है, नियरेस्ट में. ठीक,
ओके.
अगर आप 34, इफ यू आर यूजिंग 474, दैट इज आल्सो करेक्ट. ओके
ओके सर, थैंक यू.
ओके, नो आई विल आस्क द क्वेश्चन नाउ. आकिब अली, आर यू देयर? आकिब अली, आकिब अली,
yes sir.
Okay, what is the limited slenderness ratio for single lacing? Please answer, what is the limited slenderness ratio for single lacing? Open the book, no problem. I'm waiting. It means that you are not listening to the lecture. You are busy somewhere else.
No, okay. Sir, I was listening.
So, well, then it is a very simple question. Okay, Ayan. Ayan, 29 to 29, yes, Ayan. So, what is the limited slenderness ratio for single lacing? What is the limited or allowable slenderness ratio for single lacing? Ayan, I am waiting for your response. So if you do not know, just let me know. I do not know. So you don't know, Ayan? Okay, good.
So anybody net who... Band ho gaya tha, wo
net band ho gaya. Yaar, ye to
slides chali gayi.
ये तो इतनी दफ़ा एक्सप्लेन किया है यार, ये तो तुमने तो फेल हो जाओगे यार इस तरह. ये तो बड़ी सिंपल चीज़ मैंने पूछी है, इसका मतलब है तुम कहीं सो रहे, कुछ और ही गेम शेम खेल रहे.
नो सर, लाइट चली गई
यार. मैंने आई नो द लाइट चली गई, लेकिन दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन एंड आई हैव रिपीटेड इट मैनी टाइम आल्सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर. 92 रोल नंबर, 92, कैन यू हेयर मी? 92,
यस सर.
व्हाट इज द लिमिटेड स्लेंडरनेस रेशियो फॉर सिंगल लेसिंग?
75 millimeter.
Single lacing, lacing for lacing design. 75 कहाँ से ले? 75 तो हमने कभी पढ़ी नहीं कभी कोई चीज ऐसी. Okay, I will ask. Hold on, Mubin. I will ask. I'm just checking the students. Okay, Anis Malik, are you there? Anis Malik. Anis Malik.
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is limited slenderness ratio for double lacing? Double. Do not know. I have repeated it many times. Actually, I am recording also this question answer session. So later on, if you are claiming that you are failed, so I will let you know your performance. 70? Yeah, 17. I am lacing, not built up section. Lacing, for lacing design. Okay, Bilal Mirza, are you there?
Yes, sir.
what is the magnitude of shear force which is transferred from one member to the other member
in building? So vu over n sin theta.
नहीं vu कैसे आता है vu? How to compute vu? First.
सर ये वो ट्रांसफर जी सर सर ये वो ट्रांसफर जो शेयर फोर्स लग रही होती है ना वो होती है उसको हम नंबर ऑफ लेसिंग पे डिवाइड करते हैं और साइन थीटा से हम ज्योमेट्री को सॉल्व जी जी
आई एम नॉट आस्किंग fu आई एम आस्किंग हाउ टू कंप्यूट vu उसकी मैग्नीट्यूड कितनी होती है व्हाट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ vu
सर Sorry about that. Magnitude का तो नहीं आईडिया लेकिन सर
Okay, no problem. Hubeb Bhatt नाम है आपका HB405304 Hubeb यह सही but I don't know what is his name. So he is absent maybe. He just came online to mark the attendance. Okay. Okay, Miss Saleha Naeem, can you hear me? Saleha Naeem.
Yes, sir.
So, how to compute VU, shear force? Which is transferred from one section to the other section in built-up section. You don't know?
So by multiplying yes. fu n by sine theta, this one?
No, no, I'm not asking fu. I'm asking shear force, vu. Fu is the compressive force in lacing. I'm not asking that. I'm asking shear force.
0.02 into 5 cp.
Okay, 2% of the capacity of built-up section.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, Miss Zunera, are you there? Miss Zunera.
Yes, sir.
What is the limited or allowable slenderness ratio for double lacing? Design of double lacing. You know, there was one table I have shown you. For single lacing, allowable slenderness ratio is this one. Yes, 200. Okay, good. Okay. Usama Rashid, are you there? Usama?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Usama, how we decide about single lacing or double lacing?
Sir, if S is less than 380, then single lacing. Okay. If S is greater than 380, then double.
Okay, lacing. What is S value? What is S value?
Sir, center to center distance between two row fasteners.
Okay, good. Very good. Okay, now I will ask the question. If anybody know the answer, he can raise the hand. Why we do not compute the modified slenderness ratio for built-up section with lacing? Anybody else? Anybody? Only three students? Yes, four. Okay, Kamar, please explain. Kamar Habib, please answer the question.
Sir, we cannot compute the modified slenderness ratio for lacing of in built-up section because A is very small. So yes. When A is very small, R modified becomes equal to R actual.
Okay, good, very good. So because modified slenderness ratio formula A over R is will be very small, so the difference will be maybe one or two value. So we need to compute only for a built-up section with stay plate only. Okay, very good. Okay, now. Okay, Very good. All the students, I appreciate who raised the hand. Now I will ask the question to Ehtisham, Engineer Ehtisham. Ehtisham, can you hear me? Please respond. Ehtisham. Yes, speak Ehtisham. Your mic is on. I have to ask क्योंकि आपको बहुत कम समझ आ रही होती है इसलिए मैंने पूछा Ehtisham. So you do not want to answer. So it means you maybe do not know anything about today's lecture. So that's why you don't want to respond. Only maybe logging in to the MS team and doing something else. Hasan Sajjad. Hasan Sajjad, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Hasan,
yes, sir.
How to decide the thickness of N-type plate?
Sir, thickness of N-type plate.
Haan ji. कोई नहीं देख के बता दो हाँ जी तो कोई नहीं देख के बता दो कोई इशू नहीं है
सर ग्रेटर देन अगर एस पे 50 हो
यस एस व्हाट इज एस
सर एस वो दो रिवर्ट्स के दरमियान उस रिवर्ट्स के दरमियान जो डिस्टेंस होता
है ओके गुड
बोर्ड्स के दरमियान
अच्छा ठीक है ओके आमिर बशीर Amish Bashir or Amir Bashir, I don't know. Amish Bashir. Who is this? Amish Bashir, can you hear me? Maybe.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me know. How to compute the S value? कैसे compute करते हैं S value को? Distance between center line of two rows. How to compute this value? This S value, can you see this slide? How to compute this S value? So you do not know?
No, sir.
Okay. So you don't want to pass this subject maybe this year? Okay. Yes, Engineer Ehtisham, do you have any question? Ehtisham? You raise the hand. Engineer Ehtisham. Do you have any question? Yes, Uzair, please. If do you have any question, please ask. Yes, Uzair.
Sir, ये जो हमारा एस है जो हमारा डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द बोल्ट्स होता है सर ये जो हमारी एन टाइप प्लेट है और जो लेसिंग को जब हम अटैच करेंगे तो दोनों के लिए एस सेम ही रहेगा हमारा
हाँ जी एस सेम ही है एस सेम होगा
सर वो Actually, वो जो पिक्चर वगैरह आप शो करते हैं उसमें वो एन टाइप प्लेट के बोल्ट जरा क्लोज महसूस होते हैं और जो हमारी वो लेसिंग है उसकी लाइंस
दैट इज स्केच इज टिपिकल ओके स्केच इज टिपिकल एक्चुअली व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ लेसिंग The purpose of lacing is to maintain the equal distance between two sections. You understand me? It means that length of all yes, lacing will be same. So actually the diagram is a typical diagram. It is not on actual scale. For example, here you will see here, okay? You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
सर एक और चीज मैंने पूछनी थी
हाँ जी
सर सर वो जो हमने सैग रॉड के लिए फोर्सेस एफ और आर फाइंड की सर, वो आपने शायद बताया था कि जो हम वो उधर से जो हमें पहले डायग्राम्स बेंडिंग मोमेंट की दी गई है ना मैनुअल पे, उससे जो फाइंड करेंगे वो हॉरिजॉन्टल होगी, लेकिन सर बुक में उसने उसे इंक्लाइंड लिया हुआ है और उसने उससे हॉरिजॉन्टल आर फाइंड करके तो उसको डिजाइन किया हुआ है।
नहीं नहीं, एक्चुअली वो तरीका वही है, वो जो बुक में जो दिया हुआ ना वो एक्चुअली हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्स जो आपका सैग रॉड लगा जो हुआ है ना वो इंक्लाइंड लगा हुआ है, ठीक है।
यस यस सर,
जो बुक में जो शेयर फोर्स बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम दी हुई है ना, डेट आर विद रेफरेंस टू एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस, नॉट अलोंग द इंक्लाइन डायरेक्शन, यू अंडरस्टैंड मी
सर? उसने एक्स और वाई को इंक्लाइंड लिया हुआ है जिधर उसने डब्ल्यू वाई और डब्ल्यू
एक्स। यस यस, आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट आर विद रेफरेंस टू द लोकल एक्सिस। ओके, लोकल एक्सिस उसके इंक्लाइंड ही है, ठीक है, ठीक हो गया। ओके, यू आर राइट।
सर वो मुझे लगता है कि उसने शायद वो जो हमारी सैग रॉड की टोटल फोर्स आ रही है ना उसको टाई प्लेट की हॉरिजॉन्टल में कन्वर्ट करके तो टाई प्लेट को का जो सेक्शन है उसे डिजाइन किया और वही उसने फिर सैग रॉड के लिए यूज करना होना है।
यस
आई थिंक सो,
यस दैट आर एप्रोक्सीमेटली द सेम। सो व्हाटएवर इज अ टाई रॉड, बिकॉज आपका जो टोटल रिएक्शन आ रहा है वो टाई रॉड पे ही आ रहा है, ठीक है, और टाई रॉड पे कितना आ रहा है, जितने आपके सैग रॉड है ना जितने पर्लन है, if you are having 4 perlin so sag rod will be 3, you understand me? to usko 3 se fir multiply kiya tha usne,
yes sir,
theek,
yes
sir. n type plate ko agar jo design aa gaya wahi sag rod mein kar rahe hain to wahi aa jayega, theek, you are right.
okay sir, thank you.
okay, so if anyone is having the question he may ask me, otherwise I will conclude the lecture. okay, if you do not have any question then I would like to conclude the lecture. So inshallah see you the next time. So you are getting the assignment by the end of this weekend. So till then, Allah Hafiz.